The months of preparation are finally over. Both sets of fans full of optimism as they look ahead to the new season. But who will come out on top today? Stay with us. We'll have all the action for you live right here on EA TV. Hello, everyone. Great to have you with us. As you can see, we're at the Amex Stadium for this one. I'm your match commentator, Derek Ray, at the microphone. And sitting alongside me is the former Arsenal, West Ham and Coventry midfield player, Stuart Robson. And there are few more enjoyable days on the football calendar than opening day in the Premier League. It's Brighton up against Arsenal.
Thanks, Derek. Well, both teams have high hopes of how this season will pan out. I think looking at the visitors, you have to presume a Champions League place will be their target. It's key they get off to a quick start today, though.
And a look at the lineup for Brighton.
Well, I think they have a nice balance to their team. A solid back four, two holding midfielders, three creative players in advance of them, and a mobile centre forward. It's a good team.
And this is the Arsenal starting 11. Jorginho plays alongside Adrien Rabiot in central midfield. And leading the line today is Gabriel Jesus.
Thank you, the Amex Stadium. Enjoy the game.
And the contest begins. Kefren Turam, Saka, space and time for Arsenal, and cutting inside, he's got to score, and a goal it is, but offside is the verdict.
Well, it's a good finish, but he was just offside. Great decision by the assistant.
And it's Gabriel Jesus. Gabriel Jesus! A truly magnificent start. An early goal in the game. Just what they were hoping to produce.
Well, I have to say, this is a really good goal. Just look how well balanced he is. He knows he's going to be under pressure, but he shows great composure to hit the target.
Well, back underway, and 1-0 it is. Let's see what happens next. Well, he needed to read it to get there, and did. Well, the counter chance looks very real. The cross is on. Now sliding in field and searching for his second, but the keeper equal to the task.
Well, he's looking really lively, isn't he? Every time he gets the ball, he looks a threat.
A routine save. Well, it's fair to say he's been across all the back pages and the focus of social media as well. Taking on his old club, and that can bring with it a few complications.
Well, for some reason, playing against your old club can be difficult. You just feel that bit of added pressure.
Oh, it's developing nicely for them here. Well, without wanting to put too fine a point on it, that goes down as a tame effort and easy for the keeper. Not to be advised giving the ball away in that position. And not quite accurate enough, Stuart.
Well, I think he should do better there, but at least they're now knocking at the door.
Arsenal have given it away. This might be the perfect counter-attacking opportunity. Will it be sufficiently imaginative? And he stopped them in their tracks. Moises Caicedo. McAllister. Undav. Good bit of pressing. Well, doesn't have to do it on his own. An incisive pass. They are a goal down, but perhaps a chance to create something from this corner.
Well, it's been a while, but these fans are now coming to life. Can they equalise here?
Real chance. Oh, stellar defensive work to get back and win possession. Well, the referee blows the whistle, and that is going to be all for the first 45 here at the Amex. Away they go again. Second half is underway here. And plenty of scope to be creative in that wide position. Well, the attack carried an initial threat, but fizzled out. Can he finish? Nicely saved. And he's fired over the corner. Arsenal have given it away. Well, many have wondered if they would get it over the line in terms of the deal. They've succeeded, Stuart.
Well, he's a great talent. Hopefully this move will see him play at his best week in, week out. It's a really good move for everybody. Well, as you can see, Brighton have controlled the possession in the last 15 minutes and have created one or two good chances with it. If they can continue to play with this domination, it's only a matter of time before they draw level.
And the referee felt he had to blow the whistle. Well, they've decided to make a change. And in the event, just a talking to. And it's in! All square again! What a match this is turning out to be!
Well, here it is again. He's alive to the situation. He makes good contact with the ball and he keeps it down. That's a nice headed goal.
So underway again here on the back of that leveller. Determined defending. It's a perfect challenge. And we have more live Premier League action coming up for you soon on EA TV. It's Brighton and Hove Albion. Will he finish? And a goal it is to put them in front again. No less than they deserve.
Well, it's a goal you'd expect him to score, but he kept his cool and he put it away nicely. He'll be happy with that.
Into the final 20 minutes. What a big moment in the dying embers. Will it prove decisive here? And a good tackle. It's a good looking ball in behind. Oh, so close to opening up the defence. It is now with Jorginho. And the keeper was up to the task. Played over, a deft clearance. Well, from what I'm hearing, changing circumstances in the Newcastle match. Let's get the news from Alex.
It's another goal for Manchester United. It's now 4-0 with 76 minutes on the clock.
Alex keeping us right up to date.
Well, I think the fans are doing everything they can to get their team back into this. But can they find that moment of inspiration and get an equaliser?
Just the challenge that was required. Now still pressing for a goal here. But they took care of the situation defensively. Well, taking into account all the stoppages, 3 minutes to be added on. Well, let's see what they have in store for them on the break. Intelligent threaded pass here. So there goes the final whistle. It ends in a victory for Arsenal. Maximum points for them. What did you make of it all?
Yeah, it was a good result. They played well and they're now up and running. That's just what they wanted.
Well, it's normal to have high expectations where Marcus Thuram is concerned, Stuart. I wonder what you made of the part he played today.
Well, I enjoyed watching him today. His work rate, skill and movement were excellent, and he fully deserved to score that winning goal.
And it's Gabriel Gilles.
We've got some questions for you. Thank you for answering the questions.
The man to watch. 4 goals in 3 games, you can't argue with that. The action is live, next. And a warm welcome. Our venue for this game is the Emirates Stadium in North London. I'm Derek Ray, and my commentary partner here on the gantry is the former Arsenal and West Ham player, Stuart Robson. And it's all about action from the Premier League in this case. It's Arsenal, and they face Brentford.
Well, thanks, Derek. As far as Arsenal concerned, it was...
Might be a chance here. Nicely saved. Can he deliver it with accuracy? And still dangerous. Well, a time for composure on the ball. And a look at the starting lineup for Arsenal. Adrien Rabiot starts alongside Jorginho in the centre of midfield. And the striker today is Marcus Thuram. And goal news to bring you from the London Stadium. That means, without further ado, it's over to Alex.
It's a goal for Bournemouth. They've scored the opener with 11 minutes played.
Cheers, Alex. Martinelli. He could pick out a teammate. Thuram. And now Rabiot. Can they forge ahead? And you've got to say, they're good value for the lead.
Well, here it is again. He goes past his marker so easily with just a drop of the shoulder. And there's certainly no doubt about the finish. He really hits it with power and accuracy. Nothing to keep...
So underway again here, 1-0 the score. Difficult to stop him. He's in an offside position. Rabiot. Thuram. Oh, managing to beat him. Well, he missed the target and then some. Wide it went. Arsenal have given it away. Josh Da Silva. Well, something has happened at one of the other venues. Let's get the up-to-date news from Alex.
Yeah, it was a penalty for West Ham, and I think he'd be counting his blessings because it's gone off the post and it's gone in. It's now 1-1 with 32 minutes on the clock.
Thanks as always, Alex. Frank Onyeka. At times they make passing look easy. Takes the shot. Superb block. This corner kick might help them. And over it comes. Well, it still could be dangerous. Can they put it away? Oh, he's blocked it! Kefren Thuram. What a shocking pass, really. Getting forward. Oh, fine stop. Who can they pick out? Shot attempted. And using his body to good effect. Behind for another corner. Can they cash in? Well, still an issue here. So half-time, that will close the book on the first half here at the Emirates. You certainly have got to give this man high marks for his work up to this point, Stuart.
Well, Derek, he took his goal well and was a constant threat throughout that first half. I thought he showed a lot of skill to get out of tight situations, and he had a real impact on the play.
Well, it's advantage Arsenal after the first 45 minutes, but still a long way from being decided here. And there's been a goal at Villa Park, so as ever, we join Alex for an update.
It's a goal for Brighton. They're back level. It's 1-0 with 46 minutes played.
Alex with the info as ever. Kefren Turam. Well, there to intercept. Well, Spurs have been trying for a while to get this deal over the line, and now it is over the line, Stuart.
Well, at about £50 million, I think he'll prove to be an excellent signing. He's certainly got the skill and character to be a real star for them.
Oh, great attacking play. And the defender got the last touch. That'll be a corner. And with play stopped, they will make the change now. And the problem not completely solved. And problem solved for now. 30 minutes to go then. Counter-attacking, very much an option. Well, it fizzled out. I'm hearing there's been a goal at the London Stadium. That means we join Alex Scott.
It's a second goal for West Ham United. It was a low-driven cross, and he was never going to miss from there. They're back in this now with 64 minutes played.
Cheers, Alex. Pressing high, and they have the ball again. Oh, the keeper made it look routine. It was anything but. So a personnel change then. Who's going to get on the end of it? Well, a struggle to get it away properly. Oh, did so well to deny him. Growing pressure. Pressure here, and another corner. And the substitution will occur now. Favouring the short one. And firing it to the near post. And in fact, a bit too close to the goalkeeper. And that was always going to be claimed. And Alex Scott has news to bring us from the London Stadium. Alex.
It's a second goal for Bournemouth. They've pulled one back.
Now, forgive me, Alex. This could be an opportunity. They've gone and scored again. They're doing everything in their power to make sure they're not pegged back.
Well, first of all, where's the defending? They're all over the place. But give him some credit, that's a good finish. Great composure.
So back underway with the lead standing at 2-0. Well, we had to interrupt Alex in full flow there. Apologies for that. To confirm, Bournemouth have scored in that game, and that game is on a knife edge now, level at 2-2. Well, the counter chance looks very real. All hands on deck. And he's only gone and made it a hat-trick. Absolutely unplayable today. What a performance.
Well, here it is again, and it's all about the pace in transition. They're so quick to get out from the back, and he makes the finish look so easy. What a good goal that is.
Well, if there were any lingering doubts about the outcome, surely they now have been removed. Well, there's been a change to the scoreline, I'm hearing, at the King Power Stadium. Let's hear all about it from Alex. Oh, hang on, Alex. Big chance here. Oh, that's a fine save. Now they've decided to make a change. Can someone get on the end of this? The clearance wasn't decisive. Well, he couldn't quite hit the target, Stuart.
Well, it's a decent effort, but I don't think it was ever going to trouble the goalkeeper.
And the referee has deemed that an additional 4 minutes are in order. And he read it well. Not giving him a moment's peace. And the referee decides enough is enough. It's the end of the game. Arsenal victorious. That's the main headline from this one.
Well, Derek, as we've seen, they're a good team. They've got talented players and they have a decent coach. This should be an excellent season for them.
Nicely saved.
Just a couple of questions for you. No further questions, thanks.
The man of the moment. Following a hat-trick, does he have another big performance in him this time? Stay with us on EA TV. Hello and a warm welcome to a stadium that always oozes passion, St James's Park. I'm Derek Ray, and with me here on the commentary box is Stuart Robson. And very much looking forward to bringing you action from the Premier League. It's Newcastle United versus Arsenal.
Well, Derek, I think Arsenal will be fairly happy after their first couple of games. They've looked fit, they've looked well organised, and they've been good going forward. They'll certainly be hard to beat today.
Always difficult to predict in advance who might decide a game, but you could make a strong case for this man, I think, Stuart. What are you expecting to see from him?
Well, he's the most creative player on the field. He can run with the ball, he can get himself out of tight situations, he can see a pass, he's very creative with his play. I think he's going to be the outstanding player today.
And this is the Arsenal starting 11. Jorginho plays alongside Adrian Rabiot.
Oh, Derek, what a moment this could be.
There it is! A delightful start to this match. Just what they were hoping for.
Well, here it is again. He goes past his marker so easily with just a drop of the shoulder, and then the shot could not be hit any better. Struck with such venom. Great goal.
And Newcastle get the ball rolling once more. How will they react to this setback? Isak. Willock. And it's with Isak. Offside the decision. Kefren Turam. Beautifully weighted ball. It has to be. In it goes! Two goals in rapid fire fashion and looking very comfortable here.
Well, just look at his strength here. He holds off the challenge, he keeps his balance, and he finds the back of the net. It's a wonderful goal.
So underway again, and a 2-0 advantage here. Deserves credit for winning the ball back. Wilson. Well, this would help them get back into the game. Oh, he saved it well. And short it is. Laid in there by Koke. Good pressure to win the ball back high up the pitch. Well, he successfully got past him. Oh, that's fine goalkeeping. Real concentration. He's driven in the corner. A goal! And it's very much game on here.
Well, let's look at this again. It's a decent delivery into the box, and it ends up with a fairly simple finish. Certainly not much the goalkeeper can do about that.
So back underway. Intriguing contest this, given the 2-1 scoreline. Turan. Rabiot. Kefren Turan. Onto Jesus. An effective challenge. Longstaff. And a crucial intervention inside the box. Well, I believe there's been a goal at Stamford Bridge. Alex Scott can fill us in.
Yes, it's a goal for Chelsea. They're the first on the score sheet here with 10 minutes to half time.
Thank you, Alex. Koke. Always going to be the goalkeeper's ball. Saka. Counter-attacking, very much an option. And threading it forward. Really good piece of goalkeeping there. Corner kick given to Arsenal. Now the delivery, not the best clearance. And it's Gabriel Jesus, able to get a body in the way. And the electronic board delivers the news. 2 minutes of stoppage time. Well, we're at the halfway mark here at St. James's Park. I think most fans would be pretty happy with this man's display so far.
Well, I really liked his first half display. He was certainly the most influential player on the field.
Back in business and work to do for the Magpies in this second half. Well-timed tackle. And it's Gabriel Jesus. Gabriel Jesus! And it's gone in for Arsenal. Will they be stopped from this position?
Well, here's the replay. He's got such quick feet, hasn't he? Just look how he goes past his marker to get his shot away. That's a really good goal.
So there it is, 3-1 the current scoreline here. And news of a goal at Stamford Bridge. Alex, and he's broken free. Well, the keeper was called upon and delivered.
Well, he's so good in those 1v1. Moments, and he's proved it yet again.
Substitution then, let's see how it affects the match. Who can they pick out? Well, too close to the goalkeeper to really pose a threat. Well, apologies to Alex. Sometimes when exciting things happen, we have to cut her off. We don't do it too often, of course. To confirm, Leicester have scored in that match, and the match is level at 1-1. Well, we have 30 minutes to go. And a strong tackle. Well, there's been quite a bit of interest in Everton's new acquisition. This has finally gone through, Stuart.
The reported figure of around £45 million seems to be a fair deal, but he'll certainly need to settle in quickly. There'll be a lot of pressure on him to hit the ground running.
Well, news to bring you from one of the other games, and big news at that. Here's Alex Scott.
Yes, it was Chelsea that were awarded the penalty. The power on the strike, it flew in the top corner. It's now 2-1 with 67 minutes played.
Many thanks, Alex. And time for the change now. Koke. And he read it well. Callum Wilson. Great pressure to win the ball back. And the flag is up. Offside.
Well, that's just a lack of awareness. He was clearly in an offside position. Well, as you can see, Arsenal haven't had that much of the ball. But that won't bother them, because when they win it in defense...
Oh, they could finish here, Stuart. And in! Oh, yes! Exactly what they were hoping to produce. They've delivered the goal.
Well, here it is again. The through ball is absolutely inch-perfect, but I think the keeper has made a mistake here. While it's a decent finish, it should go in at that near post.
So, back underway. Newcastle certainly back in the contest. What next? Koke. Well read to ease the pressure. nearing the end of the game, and the big question is, can Arsenal see this out? Stuart, interested in your thoughts on their overall performance.
Well, what a finale we have here. Both sides have looked good going forward, but poor defensively.
Oh, they could be in here, Stuart. And space to cross it. Sound piece of goalkeeping. Sloppy in possession from Arsenal. On the attack in the closing phase. Almiron. Well, it was. So there it is, the final whistle, and a satisfying outcome for Arsenal and their many fans around the world. What did you think of their performance as a whole?
Well, it's another good display, and I have to say, a well-deserved win. They look a really strong side at the moment. They just need to keep it going now.
Well, he put in a really thorough performance here, Stuart.
Well, I thought he was excellent. Not only did he score a good goal, but his general play was outstanding. He certainly played a major part in their win here today.
Potentially.
We've got some questions for you. Thank you. That's all the questions we've got for you.
Okay, thank you for your patience. We'll start taking questions now. Okay, guys, we'll be wrapping up now. Thank you.